Hi chemistry students, welcome to my channel Chemistry Mysteries. Before I start my class, today's class, just I inform you to subscribe my YouTube channel so that you will get the latest uploaded videos and video lectures, so that you will get benefited with these classes, okay? And also don't forget to place your feedback after the completion of this class, okay? So today I would like to explain you about stereochemistry, okay? So it's very important branch of organic chemistry, stereochemistry, okay? So stereochemistry means is the chemistry of space, the chemistry of space, or three-dimensional structure of molecules, okay? Stereo is a Greek word, stereos is a Greek word which means solid, okay? Solid means, so you are going to study about three-dimensional structure of molecules in stereochemistry, okay? Stereochemistry is the study of spatial arrangements of atoms or groups in stereoisomers and their physical, chemical and biological properties, okay? Stereochemistry is the study of spatial arrangements of atoms, groups in stereoisomers, and also their physical, chemical and biological properties, okay? So that is the main aim of stereochemistry, okay? It is nothing but to study about spatial arrangements of atoms and groups of stereoisomers, and also their physical, chemical and biological properties, because solids have three-dimensional structures, okay? But the atoms are groups arranged in a space, in a three-dimensional structure. So you need to understand about the spatial arrangements of atoms or groups in that particular molecule, okay? So why we need to study about spatial arrangements of atoms or groups in stereoisomers? Because the molecular geometry influences their physical, chemical and biological properties, okay? The molecular geometry, that means the arrangements of atoms or groups in a molecule, okay, changes the physical, chemical and biological properties, okay? Therefore there is a relation between the arrangement of atoms or groups and their physical, chemical and biological properties. So that is the relationship between the spatial arrangements of atoms or groups and the properties and their properties. Therefore it is very important to learn about spatial arrangements of atoms or groups, that means stereochemistry, and therefore you will understand their structures, their three-dimensional structures and their biological properties. I'll give you one best example so that you can understand the importance of stereochemistry. Okay, importance of stereochemistry, right? So generally all the starch and so whatever we eat, the carbohydrates, okay, we eat carbohydrates. If we eat carbohydrates, okay, finally it will be converted to a smaller unit of that is D-glucose, right? D-glucose. And also in every home, so there is a table sugar, okay, table sugar, that means sucrose. Okay, sucrose is nothing but dimer of two monomer units of glucose, right? So this will be converted in the digestion, finally D-glucose. Okay, this D-glucose gives us energy in the body. Okay, that gives us energy, and it tastes sweet. Okay, and it is very useful for our energy. But whereas L-glucose is poisonous. Okay, L-glucose is poisonous. Okay, so D-glucose is very useful food, but whereas L-glucose is poison. L-glucose is poison. Okay, so what is the difference? Both have same molecular formula, they same bonding connectivity, but the only difference in their configuration. In D-glucose, the hydroxyl group is right side. In L-glucose, the hydroxyl group is left side. That means the spatial arrangements of atom or the hydroxyl group is different. The only difference in D-glucose and L-glucose is the hydroxyl group. Okay, in the case of D-glucose, it is right side. In the case of L-glucose, it is left side. So that is the only difference that makes their property different. One is very useful for food and it gives us energy, and another one is poison. You cannot eat that. Okay, so why they behave like this? One is useful and another one is poison, because of their spatial arrangement of groups or atoms, or because of their difference in their configuration. So this is the importance of stereochemistry. Okay, so stereochemistry is very, very important subject or important branch of organic chemistry. So so that you will understand all the properties of those stereoisomers, okay, and why they behave differently, you can understand very, very clearly, right? So what is stereoisomer? Okay, stereoisomers. What are stereoisomers? Okay, stereoisomers, the compounds are molecules having same molecular formula, same bonding connectivity, both are same, but difference in their spatial arrangements of atoms or groups are known as stereoisomers. Okay, stereoisomers, nothing but the compounds having same molecular formula, same bonding connectivity, but the difference in their spatial arrangements of atoms or groups are known as stereoisomers. Okay, so molecular formula, bonding connectivity same, but the only difference spatial arrangement of atoms. Spatial arrangement is different. Spatial arrangements of atoms or groups are different in those stereoisomers. That is the only difference which makes their properties influences. Okay. So in stereochemistry, the main concept, okay, the study of three-dimensional structure and their properties. Okay, so how we can study three-dimensional structure on a board or on a paper? Okay, so that means three-dimensional structure converted into 2D arrangements. 2D arrangements. 2D arrangements is on a paper or on a paper or board is known as what? Molecular representations are projections. Okay, the process of converting three-dimensional structures into two-dimensional arrangements on a paper or board is known as molecular representations or projections. So that means, so you are converting in stereochemistry the solid structure or the three-dimensional structure into two-dimensional arrangement. So this is the beauty of stereochemistry. Okay. So you will be able to understand, imagine that three-dimensional structure on 2D arrangement, okay, on converting 2D arrangement. So this is known as molecular representation or projections. Okay, molecular representations and projections. What is molecular projections or what is molecular representations? The process of converting three-dimensional structure of molecules into two-dimensional arrangements is known as molecular representations and projections, right? So there are four types of molecular projections are there, okay? Four types of molecular projections are there. Molecular projections. Four types of molecular projections. Okay, so one is flying wedge representation or projection. Representation or projection. The second one is Fisher projections or representations. The third one is Sahar's projection. And the fourth one is Newman projection. Newman projection. Okay, or representation. So these are the four types of molecular representations, projections are there. Okay, flying wedge representation, Fisher representation or projection, Sahar's projection or representation, Newman projection or representation. These four molecular representations explains the three-dimensional structure of molecules as 2D arrangements. Okay, so that means on paper we can write 2D arrangement structures. With that you are able to imagine about or understand about three-dimensional structure. Okay, so these are the representations or projections which explains the stereoisomer structures. Okay, the three-dimensional stereoisomers into two-dimensional arrangements. Okay, so let us see one by one. Let us see one by one and how, what are the models and how they explained differently. Okay, first let me explain you about wedge representation. Wedge representation, representation or projection. Wedge representation or projection. According to this representation and projection, how we can understand the structures. So firstly, he has shown four bonding models. Okay, the bonding models are four types. Okay, according to wedge representation and projection. First thing, thick or shaded lines indicates above the plane or towards the observer. Okay, thick or shaded lines indicates in this projection above the plane or towards the observer. Okay, so thick line means like this. Okay, this is thick line. Thick or shaded lines indicates above the plane or towards the observer. Okay, the second bonding model is B, dotted lines. Okay, dotted are broken lines indicates below the plane or away from the observer. And the third one is, if the bond is like this, okay, solid line indicates in plane. Okay, The fourth bonding model is the wave-like model. Wave-like. Okay? Wave line indicates no proper stereochemistry. Okay, so these are the four bonding models explained by Wedge, flying wedge. So this is called Wedge representation or projection. Okay, so according to Wedge representation and projection, thick lines or shaded lines indicates, that means the atoms or groups which are connected with thick line or shaded line, that means you need to understand that they are above the plane and or towards the observer or viewer. Okay, whenever the wedge structures, if you see the dotted or broken lines, that indicates those atoms or groups attached with broken lines in that structure, that means they are below the plane or away from the observer or viewer. Okay, you need to understand like that. The third one, the solid lines, indicates that they are in plane. They are in plane, okay? And the wave-like lines, if you find in this projection, that means there is no proper stereochemistry, not known stereochemistry at that position, okay? So if you remember these things, it is very easy for you to understand about Wedge projection, and so that you can convert three-dimensional structure into 2D arrangements on this board or paper. Okay, so I'll give you some examples. I will give you some examples how we can write structures. Okay, generally a central carbon atom attached to four other atoms or groups. Okay, if they are different, that central carbon atom is called chiral center. Okay, right. So suppose the carbon, I'll give you example, like CH4 is the methane. Okay, carbon, hydrogen, is the hydrogen. Okay, so this is the tetrahedral structure. So that means four different atoms, they arranged in a different way. So I'll show you how they arranged like that. Suppose like this. This is the tetrahedral structure. Okay, one hydrogen arranged in here, another hydrogen this side, another hydrogen this side, another hydrogen is this side, tetrahedral structure. Okay, so that means, so these two are in one plane, and this is the towards the viewer, and this is the away from the viewer, this. Okay, in this tetrahedral structure, these two hydrogens in plane, and this hydrogen arranged towards the viewer or observer, this hydrogen arranged away from the viewer or observer. Okay, so this is the tetrahedral geometry of carbon in CH4. Okay, so this thick or shaded line indicates that this hydrogen arranged towards the observer or viewer. This dotted line hydrogen indicates that this is away from or the observer or viewer. These two solid lines indicates they are in the one plane. Okay, so this is the way you can represent by wedge projection. Okay, wedge projection. So I'll give you some more examples. Okay, sometimes you can write like this also. Okay, hydrogen and hydrogen, A, B, C, D. So that means the C hydrogen is towards the viewer or observer, the D hydrogen away from of the observer or viewer, these A, B hydrogens are in one plane. Okay, so this is the bonding model of wedge projection or representation. Another example I'll give you. Another example. Suppose meso tartaric acid. So that means COOH. OH hydrogen OH hydrogen COOH. So this is the structure of meso tartaric acid according to wedge projection. So that means these both the carboxylic groups are away from the viewer or observer. These horizontal groups, arrangement of atoms or groups, are towards the observer or viewer. Okay, this hydroxyl group, this hydrogen, this hydroxyl, horizontal groups towards the observer or viewer. These vertical line groups, attached, vertically attached groups, away from the observer or viewer. Okay, so this is the way wedge projection is like that. Another, I will give you another example. Okay, this is ketone, cyclic ketone. So you can indicate like this. So this thick or shaded line, that means this hydroxyl group towards the viewer, and this dotted or broken line hydrogen, that means the hydrogen is away from the viewer, away from the observer. Okay, so that is another example. I'll give you one more example about this hydrogen CH3. This is the geometrical isomer hydrogen CH3. Okay, so this is the cis isomer geometrical isomer. So that means hydrogens attached with broken lines means that two hydrogens away from the viewer or the observer, this shaded or thick lines indicates that CH3 groups arranged towards the viewer or observers. That is the way you can understand about wedge representation or projection. Okay. One more example, alene example I'll give you. Okay. CH3 H H CH3. This is the, so that means these two groups are out of plane. These two groups arranged in plane in this alene. Okay, this hydrogen away from the observer viewer, the CH3 is towards the observer or viewer. So both are out of plane. One is other side, another one is opposite side. But about these two groups or atoms attached to this carbon are in same plane. Okay, in plane. So this is another example. So I'll give you one more example and move to the next representation or projection. And this okay, so that means, so they are like this. So that means they are perpendicular to each other. This both the rings perpendicular to each other. Okay. So this ring is in this way and like this. Okay. So this is one Benzene ring. This is another one. Okay. So this is in plane. In plane, this ring is out of plane. Out of plane means this side is away from the viewer, this side, thick line side, is towards the viewer. Okay, so this is the way you can represent according to Wedge representation and projection. So just I'll summarize about Wedge representation and projection. Okay, according to Wedge representation or projection, the shaded lines or thick lines indicates those are the atoms or groups towards the viewer or observer. The broken lines or the dotted lines indicates they are the groups are away from the viewer or the observer. So the solid lines indicates that they are in plane. Okay, in plane. So the wave like bonds shows that, so no proper stereochemistry at that position. Okay, so these are the four things you need to keep in mind about Fischer Wedge projection. The next one is Fischer projection. So according to Fischer projection, molecule represented by cross section, okay, molecules represented by cross section. This is the cross section. Okay. So every every cross section is a carbon atom, central carbon atom. So that means this one here, so this is the carbon atom, central carbon atom. Okay, so if central carbon atom attached to four different atoms or groups, is known as chiral carbon, okay, or asymmetric carbon, chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon, call cut J. So if central carbon atom attached to four different atoms or groups in the cross section, okay, so it is considered as chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon. Okay, or if the four groups are not different, they may not be chiral carbon. Okay, in this Fisher projection, so you have to arrange maximum number of carbons in vertical line. Okay, so if you have a carbon chain, okay, see that you should arrange maximum numbers should be covered in vertical line. Okay, so arrange maximum number of carbons in vertical line. And finally, place on top the most oxidizing group and write at bottom minimum oxidation group. Okay, so these are the things you need to consider if you want to write the Fisher projection formulas, right? So the molecule represented by cross section, okay, every cross section is a carbon atom. You should whenever the vertical line, horizontal line crosses at one point, that center should be considered as carbon atom. Okay, if central carbon atom attached to four different atoms or groups is known as chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon. Okay, and in Fisher projection, you have to arrange maximum number of carbons in vertical line. Okay, the chain should be in vertical line. Okay, and so you have to keep the most oxidizing group on the top in that vertical line, and the minimum oxidizing carbon group should be at the bottom. You should take care of. So what are the oxidation and how you can give priorities? Say for example, carboxylic acid is the most oxidizing group, and aldehyde group and alcoholic group CH2OH, and finally alkane group. So this is the order of oxidation. Okay, this is the order of oxidation. So that means, so you have to keep, if there is a carboxylic acid in that structure, carboxylic acid should be on at the top position. And if you have CHO and CH3, CHO should be at the top and CH3 at the bottom in the chain, in vertical line. Okay, so this is the order by which you can choose which is most oxidizing group and which is less oxidizing group. Okay, so always keep maximum or the most oxidizing group at the top in vertical line and the minimum oxidizing group at bottom. So that is the care you need to take. So this is about Fischer projection rules and guidelines to represent the three-dimensional structure in 2D arrangements. Okay, I'll give you examples. Okay, so example, I'll give you one example. Okay, example is D-glucose structure, how you can write or how you can represent according to Fischer projection. Okay, so so this is the vertical line CHO and CH2OH, OH, OH and H, OH and H, OH and H. Okay, so let me explain you about all the guidelines have we followed or not. Okay, the first thing, so we have shown like cross sections, vertical lines and horizontal lines according to Fischer projection, and so we have taken care that maximum number carbons are in vertical line 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, this 6 carbon chain is in vertical line, so according to Fischer projection, so you have to write the maximum number of carbons in vertical line. Okay, and also the next rule we have followed that among the CHO and CH2OH, CHO is most oxidizing group, so therefore CHO wrote on the top and CH2OH at the bottom. Okay, so this is the way you can write Fischer projection formulas or Fischer representation of different three-dimensional structures. Okay, so this vertical groups which are attached, vertical groups are away from the viewer according to Wedge representation. The horizontal groups are towards the observer or viewer. Okay, so this is about Fischer projection or Fischer representation. So these are the two representation, so you need to keep in your mind and you can practice them at your home. And another two representations and projections I'll explain you in the next class. And also in the next class I'll explain you about the interconversion from one projection to another projection. So how you can convert from one wedge projection to how you can convert them into Fischer projection to Saha's projection and also Newman projections. So those are the things I am going to explain in the next class. Please don't forget to subscribe this channel. Okay, so whenever I upload a new video lectures, so you will get notifications if you subscribe my channel. And also don't forget to give your feedback after listening this class. Thank you so much. Bye.